Welcome to the Was.
Was.
A nostalgic look at the past coupled with trending current events. On this episode of the Was.
Was.
If you're a fan of outer space, then you're probably at least a little familiar with the U.S. government agency that calls itself NASA, also known as the National Aeronautics and Space Administration. Established in 1958, NASA became the face of the United States space exploration program, and for the children who grew up dreaming of traveling to distant galaxies when they were young, it was the premier pathway to getting off planet Earth as an esteemed astronaut. Just like any great entity that thrives in the minds of people and children, because let's face it, children are people too, NASA's brand was crucial to the enduring mission that the agency adhered to. That brand, oddly enough, had two public faces. One was the original meatball, as it was commonly referred to, and the other was the worm, which was a more modern and graphically superior typographical representation of the agency's acronym. Recently, after being somewhat retired for almost 30 years, the agency decided to feature its worm logo again on the side of SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket, which will be carrying the company's Crew Dragon capsule and its astronaut occupants to the International Space Station in May of 2020. It's a decision that might be divisive for those who love or hate either of the two very different NASA visual identities. No matter how you teeter when it comes to the totter of NASA's brand, we're sure you'll find comfort in knowing that space exploration is alive and thriving again. And the simple notion that someday soon we'll be mining the moon and landing on asteroids like a Bruce Willis boss should keep those childhood dreams orbiting the minds of future explorers for years to come. And that's what was. Get more was at speakinghuman.com/was.